In this video, you'll get a behind the scenes look at Summit Integrated Systems. They are the team of designers, craftsmen, and installers behind multiple AVL systems you've seen featured on this channel. Life Church, Red Rocks Church, and Deer Creek Church are all clients of Summit. And you guys saw how they recently gave my live streaming video rack a complete makeover. Now it's time to take a look at the team and systems behind it all. Welcome to Summit.
My name is Nick Kofall, and I'm the Chief Vision Officer here at Summit Integrated. We're an audio, video, and lighting company that works with churches all over the country. So we work with all kinds of churches, from big to small. It doesn't really matter to us. What we're really trying to do is when anybody comes along and says, hey, I've got a building project or an upgrade that I want to do, whether it's, you know, hey, we need a new PA system or we want to do a full broadcast lighting upgrade or something like that, they would reach out to us. We'd work with them to try and figure out who they are, what are they trying to accomplish, what are the needs, what are the pain points, some of those types of things, and then work with any necessary contractors that might also help or be a part of the project as well, whether that's a general contractor or an architect or even an electrician. But we try our best to go, this is what the church is trying to do. Let us understand who you are and then translate that to technology. Sometimes that means it's tens of thousands of dollars for the budget, or that means multiple millions of dollars worth of budget to play with. But we work with all of those churches from, you know, any size or any scope.
So I'm Tyson Weens. I get to be the Chief Operating Officer here at Summit. So when we get to sign on with a different customer, we start our process in the engineering. We do a lot of drafting through Vectorworks, through CAD, and test that against the budget. Does this goal and does this product meet the budget? And once we get through that, we get to start ordering the gear. And part of our warehouse here at Summit is being able to stage a lot of that equipment. So we bring a lot of our deliveries in here. We bring in the product, we organize it, we test it again to make sure it's ready to go for on site, and then we start to palletize it so our crews can be efficient out in the field. And once we have it all ready to go in here, we actually start to assemble a lot of our product here in our Colorado warehouse as well. We have the inventory system called round colored stickers. It's pretty high tech, so now we really just want to keep track of all our gear. And for every job that comes in, they've got a color, a sticker we slap on the box so our team knows what that gear's for. We know where it's supposed to go. We even have a system down where we know which room that goes into when we get to the job site. So we can take all the, say, orange colored pallets and put them in the kids' room.
Well over 20 years ago, Summit got started with our founder, Chris Rayburn. Chris Rayburn had a bike assembly business where he would assemble bikes for Walmart and Target and a handful of other things. But his father has been in the audio industry for years and bid a project where he needed to get some labor and ultimately reached out to Chris and said, hey, would you and your guys be willing to come and install 900 speakers in an office building? And the rest is history. In 2008, we were able to make the shift and transition into only doing church work. We stopped doing the Dave and Buster's and the Chili's and, you know, those types of things, because truthfully, that work didn't really blow our hair back and really wasn't exciting to get out of bed in the morning with. But when 2008 happened, we were able to just kind of focus solely on church, because most of our team are church guys. They've either run sound in churches or been technical directors or been a part of church staff in some way, shape, or form. And so that was really where our heart was, and we've been doing that ever since. Yeah, so the facility that we're in right now, we actually just moved in January, pre-COVID. But before that, we were in multiple little small units, just not that far from here, probably another, you know, 5-10 minutes up the road. But we only had about 12,000 square feet there, but our team was spread out over multiple different kind of units. And so for us, we always dreamed about how could we get everybody back together, get everybody under one roof, foster collaboration, and really just create a space that was really beautiful, not just for our team, but also to host. We really enjoy bringing people here and doing design workshops and doing different things like that. And so we now are located in Louisville, Colorado. We're now in 30,000 square feet. So we have more than enough room to be able to kind of stretch our legs, bring people together, have a lot of fun, foster community, and really host people well.
So this is our assembly room, and we have a team who works in here. When we get our gear in, we want to do as much work in Colorado as we can. We have a very controlled space where we have everything we need right at hand. It allows us to be efficient in the work. It allows us to have the type of connectors we need, have the type of fasteners we need, where we can bench test our gear, where we can program our gear. So when it comes to the job site, we're able to set it and make a few adjustments and really move forward a lot quicker by doing that. So this space is where a lot of things happen, where we learn a lot. So as Nick was talking about earlier, we take a lot of pride in the quality of work we do. We view our team as craftsmen. They're not just laborers. They work for us full time. They love the vision of what we do, and we want to create a craft of what we deliver. So, you know, the equipment racks is always one place you look for that. And really, there's a lot of intentionality behind everything we do in it, from how we mount things vertically to how we lace in and wire, put labels on wires, because what we think about is how it's gonna be used. When a church tech director, when something doesn't work on Sunday, he needs to go be able to look in his rack and know how to fix it, know the first step to do, to say, how do I get a solution? Because nobody can respond within an hour and be on site as an integrator. You need a fix in 30 minutes. So if that tech director can pull up his functional drawing, see wire number 114 is in this router channel and see that there's an open router channel on 48, he's got a fix. So being able to use their equipment well is more important than to always just have it looking perfect. Yeah, this is one of our jobs we have in this week that's in its finishing stages. So what we're doing here with all our patch cables is getting our network switches programmed. We've got a lot of the Dante switches that need a little bit of initial programming. And then we're getting our routers and our switchers with the first pass of labeling done, testing all our inputs and outputs so we know that when we get to the field, half the system is already tested. We'll go ahead and do wireless frequency plans. We'll do audio patch sheets. We'll go ahead and program our amplifiers. So that's what we're trying to do with this. We've all got the console out ready to go as well, so that when we're there, it's ready for the user to step in. And one other really neat thing we do in this space is we actually at times will bring customers in to our warehouse to start learning their gear. So 2 or 3 months out from a building opening, when we have all their equipment here, we actually ask them if they want to come to our warehouse, and we'll have 2 or 3 days of training of get to know your console, get to know your gear, get to know the Summit team more. Because no matter how good of a system we put in, if the customer doesn't know how to use it, it's a fail for us. So that transition and that handoff is really important time, and that's another important part of how we built our space. One thing we've worked a lot on over the past couple of years is our drafting. And one big thing we've done to that is we've gone digital with all our drafting. And we use a program called PlanGrid that allows us to have live users in the same drawings. So our engineers and our assembly team and our fabrication team and our installers can all have the same drawing open and see live markups across it. So if we need to change a wire label or a wire number in the assembly room, that can auto update straight to our team in the field. Back when we had paper drawings, there was 4 or 5 sets of those, and all of a sudden you had to question which one had the right information. So what this has allowed us to do by having everything digital is quicker information transfer and far more accurate information. We take a lot of pride in the time and detail we spend in our drawings. Again, we use it as a user manual and a way to transfer information. So if an electrician needs to know how many circuits are in our amp rack, that's really important information for him to know. But also equally, it's important for the user and the customer to understand what the wire labels are and where everything goes. All that's in our drawings, in our as-builts, and it's really accurate because it is a real-time document now.
You know, stewardship is not just do it all yourself and be as scrappy as humanly possible. I think really we see a lot of inefficiencies and a lot of dollars wasted when it comes to systems that are, you know, designed in-house and, you know, a couple guys kind of throw some speakers up and do some different things. I mean, I think that's cool, and I actually have a respect for that desire to be a good steward. And I think that stewardship is at the forefront of everything that we do. But I think there's this place of we bring experience and knowledge and insight to the table to help people do it right the first time. because it's more than just the dollars that you're spending. It's about making sure that the pieces that are selected for the systems that you're trying to build actually are going to serve you well for years to come. We try to take all those different moving parts, bring them together into one clear, concise vision, and be able to execute for a church as best as humanly possible. We're not trying to just chuck stewardship out the window. We're trying to look at the bigger picture of what stewardship actually means. So currently, Summit, we're roughly around 55 or 56 people, something like that. And half of that would be guys in the field installing. We're kind of OCD when it comes to our projects. And we say that with all seriousness. And for us, it's a thing of being able to say, hey man, we don't outsource any of our work. We're trying our best to be able to control the project from soup to nuts. Yeah, so I mean, currently we're located in, you know, just outside of Boulder, Colorado, kind of smack dab between Boulder and Denver. And, you know, I think there is kind of this conception that, you know, hey, we're in this Rocky Mountain region and that's all we do. Truth be told, 90, 95% of the work that we do is outside of the state of Colorado. We do a lot of work in Texas, a lot of work in the buckle of the Bible Belt of Oklahoma and Kansas and that sort of thing. But man, we've really started to kind of stretch a little bit more. We're a nationwide integrator. And so with that, and the pandemic being what it is, we have started to really just open up the possibilities of going, what would it look like to have a remote workforce? Because of the pandemic, one of the things that's come out of this is we've all become very comfortable with Zoom calls. And we've become very comfortable with trying to figure out how do we still create community, foster collaboration, and grow as a team, even though we're all working remotely at this point.
We're really excited about this space. This is something new for Summit. When we moved into our new facility, we were actually able to invest in some machinery. We got a laser engraving machine and we got a CNC machine that allows us to do a lot of custom metalwork, custom casework, and a lot of other things. And what that means for us is flexibility, customization, and speed and efficiency. When we had to outsource our plate work, there's usually a 5 to 6 week lead time that really limited what we could do with that. And as we start to produce some different Summit Go packs and some portable systems, there's a lot of features and functionality that are really, really helpful that we are able to do our own metalwork for. So in this area, this is the beginning of our training area. As I said earlier, we employ our install team, our technicians and our foremen full-time at Summit. They're not contractors. So we get to invest in them a lot and train them a lot. So a lot of the team who works for us in the install world doesn't necessarily have the experience coming in, but they have a heart and a passion for what we do and an attitude for what we do. So we want to invest in them. We show them what it means to hang TVs on drywall. We show them what it means to pull cable. We show them what it means to do rigging. And when we get to invest in our people, we get so much more out of them because it's a life for them. It's not just paycheck for them as well. So this is how that space is evolving. We have an area to do that now. That's something we've never had before. So what that means is our people get invested more and we get a better product in the end as well. So part of installing is we don't do a lot of work close to home. We work, 95% of our work is outside the state, so we have to be set up to operate efficiently when we're on the road. So we think about it as bringing our shop to the job site. We have carts that have all our rigging hardware, all our bolts, all our connectors. We have boxes full of our tools. We have workstations with radios and HDMI cables and all these things that we've learned over the years that we're gonna need when we do the job. So what we do is we pack those in our own trailers and we bring them with us. So when we're on the job site, everything we need is there with us. And what we can do is we can take that from one job site to another and be incredibly fast and flexible that way, because if we need to stay a day or two longer or if we need to be there a day or two early, we can do that because we have our tools and we have our trucks and we have our trailers there. So it's really been a huge benefit into serving people well. So after we've assembled everything, we've organized everything, we've inventoried it, we've designed it, we get to send it out to the field with our crew. So Alexis does a great job of palletizing and grouping all our things so they're ready to go. We've got our racks that we've already commissioned and pre-wired. They are ready to load up in the trailer that we take out with us. So this is the whole project before it's completely installed. And our crew comes in and a lot of our crew actually drives out with it, packs it up with it. So the team who takes it from our shop is usually the team who actually installs it as well. So one thing that's a little bit different with us than a lot of companies is we try not to have a heavy inventory of gear. If you call us, we try to order it when we need it. That way we don't have a lot of money sunk into an inventory of gear on our shelves. And with wire, we know what we're gonna use, so we order bulk amounts of that. We use lots and lots and lots of cable because we believe infrastructure is important. The gear may change, but the cable will hopefully last a while that connects the gear. So we stock connectors, we stock rigging hardware, we stock wire, and we order product based on the project.
You know, I think that our style and our approach is so relationally focused, and so it's just focused on trying to figure out who these people are that we're trying to work with and what is really going on within that church community, that we spend an enormous amount of time building that relationship. For us, we're not looking, I've said this in other things, like we're not looking for another business transaction. We constantly are looking for a relationship and doing work that we can all be proud of and really trying to find a place within the American church culture where we can really come alongside of people and go, man, we really care about what you're doing. We love what you're doing. We're fans of the local church. How can we help you do it even better? It's really not about our agenda. It's not about how incredibly awesome we are, the stuff that we're bringing to the table. Yeah, we want to do good work, but our good work is all about trying to honor God and lift up in the name of Jesus, even in the details of how we manage projects. And so for us, I think we just approach it differently. And I think that comes with, we bring a different intensity to the table, but it's really not about us. It's trying to figure out how can we use the tools and the giftings and the calling that we have on our life to be able to come alongside of guys who are doing really incredible work in their local community.
These guys are the real deal. Their work speaks for itself. By focusing exclusively on churches, they understand everyday needs and desires of worship and production leaders. If you'd like to work with them, click the link below and fill out the form so they know ChurchFront sent you. If your church ends up working with them, we do get a small referral commission to support the channel. After encountering so much of their work out in the wild in the field and seeing how they make it all happen at their headquarters and just hanging out with these guys for multiple hours at this point, I can confidently recommend them to help you get the job done. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.